You're just a decent fish, huh? Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King Lure Company, number one in fishing lures. Ardent, rule the water. Go on there. How do they want it presented this morning? Fast, still, a combination of all the above? How? Show me, bro. Yes, I can. Wow! Whoa, what a rocket! Look at him! Is he a TV fish or what? Wow, what a rocket! Man, I love smallmouth on top, man. How can you beat that, man? How? Killed it, and then ran like a jet. Look at him go. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh my God, is that fun. I mean, look at that, man. How in the world can you beat that kind of fishing, man? Oh, where did you got it? Oh, you're a good one too. Now there's our start to our day right there. Look at it, chunky, thick back, big belly. Oh, gorgeous smallmouth bass. You know what? He's not big enough to put in the live well for a picture, but I'm telling you, if this is how I'm gonna start my day, it is gonna be something sent from God, I tell you. Here, let's let him go. Ready? You earned your keep, boy. Bang, spoosh, out of the water. Listen, welcome back to Extreme Angler TV. This week, it's summertime. And the surface is sizzling. Water temperatures have risen. A couple times I've been out where it's been real slow. You don't want to eat on top. You just boil on it really like haphazardly. Well, maybe you'll look at it. Now, I missed one fish right away. This fish hit and went suicidal. That's why we fish for topwater bass. That's why I use that Strike King, Spitting King, because you know what? It gives me a natural high. And it's just something I just can't get enough of. It's like an addiction, catching bass with topwaters in early morning in summer. Can't beat it. Let's keep going and see if we can get some real good guys. They see it, they hear it, they eat it. You know what, here's something I'm gonna show you. I don't fish this bait all the way back to the boat. What for? I wanna cover water, find those aggressive fish in the morning. You know what, if it slows down, they show me that I gotta cast it, pause it, let it sit, that's one thing, no problem, I can do that. But when they're aggressive and active and it's summer and the water's warm, wow, this bait is gonna be put in all those high potential spots. Cover water, find them, keep fishing it, keep moving. If you find the fish in a big pod and stuff, no problem, stick on it. But if it slows down a bit, move. Far casts, it's usually in the first or second pop. It lands, it sits like this, the tense moves a bit, they find it. This ripple's gonna help big time. See, that's what I mean. That's what I want to do. That's what I'm looking for right there. Skies, diva. Man, you are fun, aren't you? You gonna come up again? You're not the biggest guy I'm seeing so far today. But man, you pull like a bully. You are gonna be a bully someday. Look at you. You are gonna be a bully. So I'm gonna catch you, hopefully. Take the hooks out, and I'm gonna release you. So somebody else can go and have some fun. Like, how can you not like that? Look at that, that's nuts. That's absolute nuts. Nuts. Look at that. Another gorgeous little fish. Look at his eye, all beady, looking at me. What do you say, boy? Huh? Don't worry. I got a lot of respect for you boys. Go on, get down there. Go on, get down there. But you know what? I'm telling you, I'm going to be truthful. I've got a 1-2 punch here today. That's not the stickworm. The stickworm is for the topwater. If I miss boils and strikes and stuff. But I've got a little KVD Squarebill crank. Small little bait. And it's made for real shallow water fishing. But I'm fishing only between 4 to maybe 10 feet. So it's still kind of shallow. But these smallmouth are just below the surface, 2 feet down. And I'm getting, I'd say, 1 out of every 5 fish that I see on the sonar come up and eat it. They're not real crazy. So if my number one game plan fails, I got a backup that hopefully will put more fish on camera for you to see and for me to have fun. We'll find out. All weed here. You see what I mean? You see what I'm talking about now? How they slash at it? When they want to just kill it. When they want to eat it, they crunch it. Today, they want to kill it, then maybe eat it. But in their mind, it's bugging them. I'm instigating, inspiring, provoking strikes. You little bait are a provoker. That's why I like you. You know, there's nothing like catching them on top. Spitting King, KVD Splash, Sexy Dog, it doesn't matter what it is. But if I want to keep catching fish, and I can move around and potentially find more fish, some different sizes that are just slashing at this. What the fish have shown me so far this morning is they're slashing at it. I got one fish in the side of the mouth over here. I'm jumping over it, bumping it. It shows me they're not real aggressive. I'm provoking the strike. So what I do is have a backup plan, and that is a small subsurface bait. In this case, the little KVD Squarebill. It's made to run shallow, bumping off wood and stumps and that kind of stuff, but I'm finding these fish just below the surface. So it's not gonna run deep. It's gonna stay in that zone where they are. So I'll go back and forth. Spitting King, Squarebill, and hopefully it'll help me catch more fish, put them in the boat, take some pictures, and let them go. Let's see. I'm in a fantastic area with weeds, bait fish, perfect depth, contour edge. Everything is just right. I know the fish are here. They're not committing the Spitting King. Do I move? Do I keep doing it? I'm gonna stay, but I'm gonna try that little Squarebill right there. Something maybe they haven't seen today, ever. Let's see. You know, one of the biggest things for me is always having a backup plan. I wanna catch them on top water, that's fantastic. Being prepared, stickworm or drop shot, jerkbait, whatever it is, man, but this crankbait, I'm fishing on a big, wide flat, and you gotta have something. You can cover water efficiently and productively. But I've seen the fish this morning in the sonar up high, real high, and some committed to the top water, but that little Squarebill dives down about a whole foot, 18 inches. It's perfect. Yep, that one I think is a smallmouth. Incredible. Exact same spot where I've seen them come up and bust my bait and miss it. And about the third cast with a little Squarebill, look where it is. Take a good look at that bait. Then his mouth, I'd say, he didn't slash that. He tried to eat that. Look at that. Yeah, man. That's the way to do it, boy. I'm telling you. When it comes together, it makes you feel like a superstar. I did say when it comes together, huh? But when you back up plan, it can work like that. See that? Nice, chunky, brown, Canadian smallmouth. I'll let you go, boy. KVD, little Squarebill right there. What does he say? That is money. No matter where it is, Bassmaster Classic are out here on Cottage Country, Ontario. You want to catch them? Pick up the Spitting King or the little KVD Squarebill, because you know what? Fish cannot resist them. Just like me. Let's find a big one. Okay, when that bite starts to slow down, it gets real slick like this. Like, look at it. It's like glass, like ice. You think, okay, it's fantastic for top water, but it's not. So with the crank, where I got to put that is almost like ambush positions near a rock, an edge, a weed bed, something where those fish can see it, boom, dart out, maybe eat it, and go back to productive areas where you've caught, where potentially those fish maybe go out, gone in, eat, come back again, and it's almost like the second dinner bell. Time to find another fish that wants to eat that little square bill running by those little ambush positions. Got him. Good one too, see? Good one too. Let him come right to the boat. Thinks he's smart. Yup. Look how he ate it too. I tell you, man, having a backup plan is so important. Let him fight. Look at that rod, just pulls it down. You pounded that too, look at that. He pounded it, got him under the chin. Under the chin. I'm gonna net him and then release him. Decent little fish. But look what you got it, didn't you? Again, you pounded it. You didn't really want to eat it, did you? You pounded it. And because it looked real. And because it looked real, you had to try to eat it. Look how fat you are. These guys are just bulking, man. Summertime and the fishing's good. And a little square bill with the topwater is getting the deal done. It's so important just to have a game plan. And when it comes together, you feel like KVD.
Cottage Angler, tips and tactics to make you a better fisherman.
Hey, I'm Mark Davis, and we're gonna talk about fishing a deep crankbait. And what I have here is a Strike King Series 6. Of course, it's designed to fish structure, it's designed to run deep. And most people don't think about fishing cover with it. And the cover I'm talking about is, it can be wood, it can be grass, it can even be big boulders, but any, and what I'm really talking about here is fishing this lure in an area where most guys would not fish a crankbait. Trees, for example, you know, laydowns, brush piles. They're always afraid, you know, that they're gonna lose their bait. If they cast it in there, they're gonna lose it. You're gonna get hung up. And I've got a little technique that I do. It's what I call finessing a crankbait. And right here is exactly what I'm talking about. I'm using my rod, I'm fishing through these stumps, and you can see my rod tip. I'm just using my reel to take up slack. Just like you would with a jig or a worm. And you gain all that control and feel by fishing it this way. Now I could make that same cast I just made and move that lure with my reel, I guarantee you I'll hang up. But by fishing it with my rod, sweeping it along and finessing it through there, you don't hang up. I stopped using the reel to move the lure. I'm just using the reel now to take up my slack. I'm just pulling that bait. Same thing you do with the jig, same thing you do with the worm. Most people tend to want to fish a crankbait that way. And if it's really shallow, I'll even get my rod up here at 10 o'clock. And I'm finessing it through. Letting that bait deflect off that cover. I'm not hanging up. And don't be afraid to cast a crankbait in there where most guys fish a jig. Give it a try.
Another thing with throwing a crankbait, you gotta figure out the cadence the fish want. Do you want it burnt, going crazy? Today, what I found is twitching it, stopping it, quick, stop, go. And I had bites all the way. When I casted it, some of them blew on it right away, some after a few turns of the handle,
someone had stopped. So it wasn't just one particular way. It was, you know, Heinz 57 of casting, twitching, jerking it, making it look like something injured or on its last breath. So these bass were opportunistic, looked at it, decided I'm either going to eat it or I'm going to hit it and kill it. At that time, nice smallmouth. Look at him. Oh boy. Awesome. Pick up that crankbait. Little squarebill. Look at that rod go, eh? Hasn't got the length of a giant, but he's got some girth. Oh, look at that. Just a fat little fish. He looks so big in the water. He looks so tough. But at the end of the day, you see that squarebill, you had to eat it. Look where it is. One in the nose, one in the side of the app. They sure look good. Put them in there. Take a photo of him. Let's see. But I need a couple that are way bigger than that, don't I? I need some real good ones. And for me, you know what? It's about catching fish. And whatever I got to do, but I want to fish and have fun at the same time. So a topwater bite, the spitting king, or the KVD splash, sexy dog. You know, when it's calm like this and it's summertime and it's warm, they are my first choices. Catching a few fish, but I see that it slows down. I have a backup plan, either stick worm, maybe a drop shot, but I like that visual stuff or covering water on flats, and that's what I'm doing. The Squarebill or the Deep Diving Pro Model Crank is the answer for me, and it could be for you too. It just goes to show you, man, people think that sometimes you gotta throw crankbait and spinnerbait and stuff when you got the chop and, you know, those conditions where the baitfish get disoriented and stuff. Look at it out here. It ain't choppy, ain't it windy, but it's just a matter of picking the right presentation, the right bait, and use it the right way. Make it look dead, make it look like something that's, you know, dying on its last breath, and it's opportunistic for those bass to come out of those little hiding spots near weed, rock, regardless of the surface conditions. Crankbaits will catch fish all the time. Like a switch got turned on. How's that one? I think that was almost like a topwater bite. As soon as it landed, kapoosh. I think he was hungry, don't you? Look how tough they are. See, that's always a way to provoke him to strike, isn't there? Look how tough they are. Tough, tough, tough. You just let them wear out, let the rod do it. Oh, he ate it too. He did eat it, look at him. As soon as it landed, he decided it's done. Oh boy, it's on the edge now. Is he gonna come in the boat? He is. That's him, that's him. That's it right there. Look at that. That's a little Canadian football. Look at him. Not a giant at all, eh? I'm gonna put him there. No, you know what? He earned his freedom. He ate it right away. He earned his freedom right away, didn't you? Yes. Ready? Go on. Wow. That's the second time that's happened. Throw the crankbait, hits the water. Before he can even do one turn of the handle, it shows you landed right on top of a fish who wanted to eat. So he probably ate the top water. But you just got to have that gut instinct to know when to use top water, squarebill. And it's getting real hot. I'm getting hot. I'm almost done for the morning. But you know the saying, one more cast. Right, Shaw? One more cast. Let's go. It's like a topwater bite with a crankbait, man, I tell you. I know why Kevin uses it so much, man. All those Hackney and Grigsby and Davis and stuff. Davis calls these little things a little bird dog. You know why? They zig and zag and bump off stuff. They go in all the little nook and cranny little areas along weed edges, rock and weed and wood and all that kind of stuff where bass like to hide. Large, smallmouth, Kentucky, it doesn't matter. If it's a bass, it'll eat that little squarebill. You know, it doesn't matter how you're fishing with soft plastics, jigs, topwaters, or today with me with the topwater and the squarebill. The right rod, 7.2 St. Croix, medium heavy, Legend Extreme. I could feel those real subtle little ding because they weren't really hammering it. 8-pound gamma fluorocarbon, digs down. It's a perfect line for me. That squarebill, obviously the bait when they wouldn't eat the topwater. But those long casts, covering water, the Ardent Edge Elite, hard to beat it, man. And the drag technology, those small ones they pulled by the boat, it didn't matter. I didn't lose any fish by the boat that pulled off those little hooks, because that drag system, the drag tracking, A1. There he is. What are you? Smallmouth? Yep. Look at him down there. Big fat head on him. Sitting by those weeds, huh? Like a train. Choo choo. It don't matter to me. You all fun. Whoa, he's in the net. And he's a fatty. Whoa, look at that. Look at that. You say net him or grab him. I say net him. And that fish right there concludes my day of broadcast. You know the live well for some pictures. Then I'm going to let you go. But that fish with that bait, square bill, and the spitting king has made my day on a slick, beautiful, calm summer day. Next time you're out, have a backup plan, topwater, and the square bill, and I'm sure you'll do the same thing I did here today. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler TV.
Daiichi, world's sharpest hooks. Snag Proof, the leader in weedless frogs. Gamma Fishing Lines. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.